Hello everyone, I'm Chintala, Senior Product Manager at Snowflake. Today, I'm super excited to show you how easy it is to build and deploy a machine learning model using Snowpark for Python, which is now in public preview. Let's continue where we left off with Tyler's streaming data pipelines in the previous video. As the number of products and the number of online advertising channels for SportsCo have grown, it's taking more and more time for marketing to understand how much money to spend on advertising each month. As a data scientist at SportsCo, I'd like to build a machine learning model to help shed some light on how to allocate advertising spend across the various channels to generate the highest ROI each month. This will then help our marketing teams make better informed decisions and accelerate their monthly planning process. I will use Snowpark for Python, which is now in public preview, to do some feature engineering tasks and construct a dataset of historical spend per advertising channel and total sales. Also using Snowpark, I train my machine learning model over the prepared dataset and deploy the trained model as a Python user-defined function or a UDF so that business teams can request predictions on demand or incorporate it into an application. I'll open my Jupyter notebook where I typically do my development and exploratory analysis. Using the Snowpark API, it's quick and easy to establish a secure connection between Snowflake and my local notebook. To get started, I do a quick preview of the campaign spend materialized table Tyler created. This table contains 10 years worth of streaming ad click data that has been aggregated to show daily spend across all of our digital ad channels, including search engines, social media, and more. The total cost or spend per channel will be the inputs to the model. But the data is not yet in a format where it can be merged with the monthly revenue table that the marketing team uses to track revenue from paid ads. Snowpark's data frame abstraction makes it effortless to work on data with Python. I first aggregate data for each channel on a per month basis. And then I pivot the table. This way I have each channel as a column with the aggregated spend for each month. Under the hood, my Snowpark Python queries were translated into SQL and run using the secure and scalable Snowflake engine. Snowpark enables me to work in my preferred language, Python, while still getting the benefits of Snowflake's elastic engine to handle all the heavy processing. Next, I join the aggregated spend per month data with the monthly revenue table. The monthly revenue will be the predicted output of our model. And before going into training, I'll exclude columns I won't need, such as year and month. I'll also do some quick checks to remove missing values. I save these features into a new Snowflake table, and now I'm all set for some model training. In the past, I had to do all my training either locally or in an external environment, which meant copying data and managing additional infrastructure. Using the larger memory instances, which are currently in development, and the pre-installed Anaconda packages, I can now run model training right inside Snowflake's highly secure sandbox environment while working with some of the most popular open source Python packages. Here's the Snowpark Python code I've written, which uses the scikit-learn library for model training. I quickly test this on a subset of data. And to run the training job over my historical data natively inside Snowflake, all I need to do is deploy this as a stored procedure. All my training code is then hosted and run using the Snowflake infrastructure. Once the model training is completed, the train model file is written out to a Snowflake stage. Now, to deploy this model for inference, all I need to do is register the model file as a UDF. Once registered, getting new predictions is as simple as calling the function by passing in data. But of course, this model is not only available to data scientists that know how to set up and use notebooks. Because the model is available as a Python UDF in Snowflake, anyone with the right access could also get new predictions from inside a worksheet. There's no need to establish connections to an external IDE, install open source packages, or manage a separate environment. Using familiar SQL, analysts and other users can also generate model predictions. Scoring new data could be an ad hoc request like I'm doing now, but it could also be part of an automated pipeline. Because Python UDFs can be called using SQL, I can make this model part of an automated pipeline and use tasks for scheduling. The automated pipeline could also include retraining of the model since that it is now designed to run inside the stored procedure I just deployed. So to summarize, using Snowpark, I was able to combine the required datasets, perform various feature engineering tasks, and create and deploy a machine learning model. I did all of this using Python and its rich ecosystem of open source packages using tools I'm already familiar with, while still taking advantage of Snowflake's scale, performance, and security. To get started and learn more about Snowpark, please visit snowflake.com/snowpark. Please tune into my colleague Adrian's demo to learn how we can turn this machine learning model into a Streamlit application.